Today, let's understand how to solve the last question from the 2023 AS level further math paper. Here we have a quartic equation. Z to the fourth power plus 5z squared minus 30 is equal to 0, and we are given that it has roots PQIS. But we don't want to solve it because the first part wants us to just find an equation, but now with roots 3p minus 1, 3q minus 1, 3r minus 1, and 3s minus 1. If you want to solve this, no, don't do it, trust me. So, what's the connection of between the new equation with this roots and the original? Well, it's 3 whatever minus 1, right? And then these are from the original roots. For the new equation, they want us to use W. So I'm going to start off by saying W is equal to, well, it's the 3, and then PQRS are from Z. So I'm going to put down Z right here, and then minus 1. That's the connection. And then I'm just going to solve for Z in terms of W. So add 1 to both sides, and then divide the 3 to both sides. So we have W plus 1 over 3. Then all we have to do is to put this into all the Z's, and then multiply it out, combine terms, and all that stuff, and then we'll be done. Okay? So let's go ahead and do that. W plus 1 over 3 to the fourth power plus 5 times W plus 1 over 3 squared minus 30 is equal to 0. And let me just take a second to explain why does this really work. Well, this is the new equation. This is the root. So if you put 3p minus 1 into here, plus 1 minus 1 cancel, 3 and minus then divided by 3 cancel, so we'll just end up with p. So we get p to the fourth power plus 5p squared minus 30 is equal to 0. That's true because p is the root of the original. So if you put p in here, fourth power plus 5p squared minus 30, you get 0. So that's the idea. So now the rest is just you do the computation and all that. So firstly though, we have the 3 on the bottom, raise that to the fourth power. I'm going to write it as 1 over 81 all the way in the front. And then to expand W plus 1 to the fourth power, let's look at the Pascal's triangle. 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1, and then 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. For more info, I do have a separate video on this. You guys can go ahead and check that out. Link will be in the description for your convenience. And thankfully, they only have like 1W plus 1. So all we have to do is 1W to the fourth power, and then plus 4. W to the third power, and then right here technically you put this to the first power, but 1 to the first power doesn't matter. So we can continue. The next one is plus 6 W square, and then times 1 to the second power, but doesn't matter. And then the rest plus 4W plus 1, just like that. Then we still have the plus 5, and then here we have 3 squared, which is 9. Let me put it right here. And then W plus 1 squared, that's just W squared plus 2W plus 1. And then finally, we have the minus 30, and all that should be equal to 0. We are almost done. The question wants us to have the leading coefficient to be 1. So I'm going to multiply everything by its denominator, which is 81, which happens to be a least common denominator. So 81 times that, they cancel, so we just have all that. All right, and then 81 times 5 over 9. So let me just do it real quick. This is 1, this is 9. So 5 times 9 is 45. So really, we are looking for 45 and then distribute inside. So 45, distribute, distribute, distribute. So we get plus 45W squared plus 90W plus 45, all right? And then lastly, we also do 81 times this. So that will be minus, so 3 times that is 243, and then we put a 0 afterward. And all that's equal to 0. So finally, we just have to combine terms, and that'll be it. All the way in the front, we have W to the fourth power. And then for the W to the third power, this is the only one. So plus 4W to the third power. S of w squared, we see this and that. So together, we have plus 51 w squared. And then for w, here we have 4w plus 90w. So that's plus 94w. And then we have this 1 plus 45 minus 2030. You can do that in your head, but I'm just going to take a look at the answer, which is minus 2384. And all that, it's equal to 0. So that is the equation that we want. So we're not solving the equation. We're trying to get another equation for the first part. Now let's take a look at the part 2. Now for part 2, we have a cubic equation. And once again, they gave us the roots. Alpha 2 alpha and alpha minus beta. And then we're going to use this to actually solve for this equation. And because you might be wondering, like, we don't even know what n is. Is this enough information? Yes. Here's the deal. We must know the connection between the coefficients of the equation and the roots. And this is also known as the Fietat theorem. So I'm going to write that down right here for you guys. If we have a cubic case, once we get to, let's say, the original equation in the standard form, ax cubed plus bx squared plus cx plus d is equal to 0. If we divide everybody by a, then we get a cubed plus b over a x squared plus c over a x plus d over c, why did I put c? D over a is equal to 0. All right, now we have the standard form with the DD coefficient equal to 1. Now imagine if you factor it and then you get the three roots. So I will put down x minus, let's say the first root is r1, and then the second root is r2, and then the third root is r3. And now if you expand it, well, I will tell you this is how I remember it. You have x cubed, and then you add, well, depends on how you want to look at. You can, this is a little bit, the negative positive signs, not the nice thing. I'm going to put that you add. If you have negative r1 minus r2 minus r3, and then x squared, and then you will have plus, and then this is just that you put two of them and you multiply them. So you have r1, r2, and you add r1, r3, and then r2, r3. Okay, and then this is with x. And finally, you will have a minus, or I should say plus, negative, like this. R1, R2, R3. All that is equal to 0. If you multiply the out, you end up with this. The connection is, have a look. We must have the product of R1, R2, R3 equal to this right here, right? Okay, so I'm going to circle that as well to make it clear. So let's go ahead and do that. But do not put it as 81. You must divide everybody by 4 first. So by looking at this equation, divide everybody by 4, we get this. And then we have the three roots. So I'm going to use the first, well actually, we will also need to use this. So I will put this down in like a box or something. This part equals that, right? They are all negative, so I can factor out negative. So I can factor out negative like this. And then I'm just going to put them all together and add them up. Here we have alpha plus 2 alpha plus alpha minus beta. This right here must be the coefficient of x squared from the original. But I don't have x squared. This is like x cubed and then plus 0x squared, right? So this right here must be equal to 0. Let me just do it like this. Right? So from here, we have one equation. Now from here, the product of all these three with a negative must be 84 over 1. So again, I will negate that. So negate and then multiply all these three. So alpha times 2 alpha times parentheses alpha minus beta. That must be 81 over 4. So these are the system, these are the equations that we have to solve simultaneously. From the first equation, the negative doesn't matter. You can divide both sides by negative. This that is 4 alpha. And then we can put the beta to the other side. So 4 alpha is equal to beta. Then we will just put the 4 alpha into here. So we get negative. This times this is 2 alpha squared. And then alpha minus 4 alpha. And that's equal to 81 over 4. This right here is just negative 3 alpha. So negative 3 alpha times this is positive 6 alpha to the third power equals 81 over 4. All right, now the rest is just usual business. So cancel. Alpha to the third power equals, let's reduce this by 3. So we have 2 and 27. So we have 27 over 8. And then alpha to the third power is equal to this. We will take the cube root to both sides. And in fact, I have to tell you, the direction says the n right here is a real number. Now I know why they gave us the real number. Because when you take the cube root, now we'll just consider the only real number, right? Which is alpha equals 3 over 2. Of course, there are other two solutions to this right here, but we are not going to deal with that because we want the coefficient right here to be a real number. So that's what we have. And then we will just have to figure out what beta is. Well, beta is just going to be 4 times the alpha, which is 3 over 2. And of course, reduce this real quick. So you see beta is equal to 6. So now we just have to plug in alpha and beta into all these expressions and then work them out, and that's it. So alpha is 3 over 2. That's the first root. Then 2 alpha is just 2 times 3 over 2, and that will give us 3. So that's the second answer. Finally, alpha minus beta. Alpha is 3 over 2, and then minus beta, which is 6. And get your common denominator, multiply the 2. So that's 12. So that will be negative 9 over 2. So the answers, we have 3 over 2, 3, and also negative 9 over 2. So these are the roots for this equation, which I find is pretty fascinating because you don't even know what n is yet, right? And you can still solve it. Now, for the last part, we are going to finally find out what n is. So once again, we will have to use the relationship between the coefficient of the equation and then the roots. This time, n is in front of the x, so we have to pay attention to the coefficient of the x here and this. So we should still divide this equation by 4. Let's look at n cubed plus n over 4x plus 81 over 4 is equal to 0. Now, for the coefficient of x, it's just the product of any two of the roots and then just add them up, right? So r1, r2 plus r1, r3 plus r2, r3. And these are the roots that we found earlier. So this is R1, R2, R3. So all we have to do now is to just do this times this. So we have 3 over 2 times 3. And then we add this times this. 3 over 2 times negative 9 over 2. And then we add this times this, which is 3 times negative 9 over 2. And all that should be equal to this coefficient, which is n over 4. So again, we're trying to match the coefficient, just like that. So of course, the rest is just you can multiply both sides by 4. So I'll tell you the answer for this right here, n will be equal to negative 63. How did I do that so quickly? Because I have the answer right over there.